Welcome to the SME 2-Minute Drill, where we cover a ThoughtSpot feature in 2 minutes or less. In this video, we're covering uploading user data. The clock is running, so let's get started. So in addition to methods like tsload as well as ETL tools, you can upload user data into ThoughtSpot if you have the correct permissions. So from the data tab, go over to the three dots, select upload data, and we'll ask you if you want to browse your files or if you want to just drop a specific CSV on here. From here, you specify if the column names are there, as well as what are the fields separated by. And then it's going to give you the option to change the column names. Once that's done, you can select the column type. Now, this is going to go based off what it profiled with the data, so please double check to make sure that your data abides by the specific column types. Once you upload your data set, it's now going to tell you, congratulations, your rows have been imported, and then give you three options where you can either link to existing data, ask a question on this data right away, or spot IQ right away. Now, please note that there is a row limit based off of how much data you upload. I believe it's about 50 megabytes. You also have to have the permission to upload the data. And once you've uploaded the data, it's not automatically shared with all of your users. So just please keep those considerations in mind before you upload your own user data. If you'd like to follow along with our 2-minute drill, you can download this exact data set from our website at the link below. Until next time, this has been an SME 2-minute drill for ThoughtSpot.